It is mentioned in Hayat al-Qulub through the narrations of Imam al-Hassan and Imam al-Hussein alayhim as-salam that when they were asked about their grandfather, the Prophet Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa alihi, they said that his nobility was visible to all those who saw him. His face was as radiant as the moon at the peak of its brightness, and his hair was neither curly nor straight, nor did it extend beyond the lower tips of his ears. His forehead was broad, his eyes wide and dark, and his eyebrows were extended and thin. His beard was dense with hair, and he kept it very neat and tidy. His nose was slender, and his mouth was not very small. His teeth were very white and glistened whenever he smiled. He loved fragrance and always adorned himself with perfume. Even when beads of sweat would form on his blessed body, to onlookers they looked like pearl drops and spread the sweet smell of musk. His limbs were long and strong. His presence was that of bravery and awe. He was a courageous fighter on the battlefield, but never reckless. When he walked, he did not drag his feet upon the ground, and he used to lower his head as if descending from a height. He never tilted his head in arrogance or looked down on anyone. He would walk with soberness and humility, his eyes downcast, more towards the earth than the sky. He would always be the first to greet people and always met them with a smile. He could speak every language, so he would talk with others in their mother tongue. He would inquire about the well-being of those he met and would ask after others if they were absent. If any of his companions were sick or in difficulty, he would make sure to visit them personally. When others would speak to him, he would face them directly and would never turn to look away from them. He was very soft with the people, and when he spoke to them, he did so in a way that was clear and easy for them to understand. He was never rude or harsh in his speech. He never talked bad of others or sat in a gathering where there was gossip or slander. He always saw the best in people and encouraged them to improve their character. He never became angry except when he saw something that was wrong, but he was always quick to educate and forgive people for their mistakes. Nobody ever felt disappointed after meeting him, because if they needed anything, he would make sure that their request was fulfilled. He was fearless in expressing the truth and held firm to his values. He was thankful for even the smallest comfort and would divide his time between worship, serving others, and taking care of his family. He respected all people, regardless of their background or circumstances, and nobody would meet him except that they would benefit from his wisdom. He would tell visitors to go and convey his words to others so that everyone could benefit from his teachings. When he entered a gathering, he would sit in the last available vacant seat and never asked for special treatment despite his great status. He was not ashamed to sit with the poor or outcasts of society and did not shy away from showing affection towards his wives and family. He was kind to animals and spoke out for their rights. He did not like flattery, but showed great appreciation when people were gracious towards him. Men admired him, women felt safe around him, and children loved his company. Everywhere he went, he spread love and kindness on the earth. He was as-sadiq and al-ameen, the truthful and the trustworthy. He was the ultimate mercy to all living creatures and the inheritor of all the prophets. He was Muhammad sallallahu alayhi wa sallam.